We are going to discuss data. I mean, data broadly, doing GIS. We have to have data to do GIS, or we have to create data to do GIS, or we have to consider the background and the origin and the provenance of our data. Well, we probably have to do all of that. Let's be honest. GIS relies on data. Our data relies on decision-making. Those not only to create the data, but then to use the data. It's all a very complex, interwoven web. So we're going to talk about a lot of data pieces in this pair of videos here, thinking about how we do GIS, how we work with data, so on and so on. And one of the first places to emphasize, and this is broadly applicable, no matter where you are in your intro GIS journey or your GIS journey, or really anytime you're working with any form of data whatsoever, we have to manage where our data is. It is an emphasis throughout the labs, I think, any GIS lab, but certainly throughout ours, is that you've got to keep track of where your data is. Where is your analysis? Where's your original data? Where are your backups? Where's the data you were messing around with and you think you figured it out, but which column had your information in it again? I don't know. At the end of the day, you're responsible for this. So organization is important and is part of our kind of universe of GIS work. But at times, our good friend ArcGIS doesn't make it that easy to organize our data. That's not necessarily our fault. One thing that Arc loves to do is set default geodatabases, and frankly, it has to. Within the program, it has to have a set location where stuff goes, where new layers go, where analysis goes. And while you, from the system perspective, are in control of where you save stuff or where you download stuff, once you bring it into Arc, it's kind of at the whims of what the program wants to do. And so the default locations, the default processing locations, the default geodatabases, the default settings, sometimes are functional, sometimes are not. You have to take control and decide when the defaults are good and when the defaults are bad. And sometimes the defaults, whether it's in how it names a file or where it places a file, actually work out well, and we can accept those, but we want to be consciously accepting those, saying, okay, that name's good. Okay, that location's good. There's nothing worse in GIS than just clicking through and hitting run and getting a cool output and then having no idea where the thing is. One way to organize and keep a view of what is happening with all of your data is to use the catalog pane. This is the screenshot of the catalog pane from ArcGIS Pro, might be familiar. Here you can organize your folder connections, your databases. Sometimes if you're using custom toolboxes, you have to connect to those, how many maps you have in your project document, so on and so on. Within that catalog reveals the defaults that you have, reveals the connections that you've made, where your data actually lives, where your analysis is going. But we can also see that in any tool that we run. And we've got new Arc, Arc Pro on the top, and then old Arc on the bottom, just to show that they show the same information in the different versions of the software. That output feature class location, or that output features location, defaults to the default. That sounds really recursive, but it's true. It defaults to either the base setting within the project that you're in, or in the case of old Arc, just the default geodatabase itself. And that's where it wants to dump your data or your analysis or whatever you might be doing. Rarely is this the best place, unless you're just testing out something or making sure something works, so on and so on and so on. The reason it's got this default GeoDatabase set up is because it has to have some kind of processing location. And based on how Arc is installed, it just sets this as the default setting. In new Arc, if you create and save a map project, it creates its own little GeoDatabase and makes its own little map project. That's actually pretty useful as long as you aren't switching computers all the time. Now, depending on how you use GIS, you might be like me and have, you know, a C user's me, and that's my computer right here that I'm talking to you through right now. I don't move my data around. My data all lives here. I'm happy with it. I do all my GIS on one machine. That might not be the way you do your GIS. You could be a student in a lab class that moves around between different lab computers. The default GeoDatabase on one of those computers is not going to be your friend. You might be someone using a virtual drive, which wipes data every time you log out. The virtual drive that deletes your stuff all the time is not the best place to leave your data. You might be someone on a shared computer in an office, and you need to put stuff in a different folder so that someone doesn't come through and wipe it or overwrite it. There are lots of ways to manage your data. Which way is right for you depends on your context. But accepting the default GeoDatabase is kind of at your own risk. This default GeoDatabase, it's just what the system settings have to do. It's like when you download something from your web browser. If you haven't changed that setting, it has a default behavior. I always change mine, but I think in Chrome, it just dumps it into your downloads folder. That's easy enough. That works. That might be the best way to do it. Or it can be really annoying and you want to take control of that. Now, a GeoDatabase is a specific type of folder. At some level, it's just a folder. But at another level, it is a specially designed location. It is set up to store and retrieve and organize spatial data. A collection of geographic data sets of various types held in a common file system folder. It's a fancy folder. But ArcGIS can use this folder in different ways than it can use like a normal folder. Some Esri engineer's brain just hurt a little bit, like a piercing migraine, because I referred to a GeoDatabase as a folder, but it's a folder. You can change the defaults. Of course, any setting is changeable. So you don't have to live with the default GeoDatabase that is set within Arc. But again, if you're moving around computers or maybe you don't have access to change this, you just might have to live with the understanding that you're going to have to make this choice every time. And honestly, that's not the worst thing. If you have to select where your data goes every time you do GIS, sure, it's a little bit of a process pain, but you will be absolutely in control of your data. That's not bad. Databases, of course, if you're seeing an attribute table is a type of a database. A database is just anything that stores data in some kind of rigorously and organized fashion, rows and columns, fields, and features. I've mentioned before, say it again, spreadsheet's a database. Why not? I have a very open definition of what a database is. Geo is spatial. If you're watching a video on GIS and GeoDatabases. Stop it. Another thing that can happen with the GeoDatabase thing is that your data might not be movable. Your data might not be easily accessible. And another thing that happens is that your data kind of gets separated. So if you're doing a bunch of analysis in a default location, but the data you're pulling that from is in another location, maybe that's a little bit unstructured in a way that could be uncomfortable down the line. Certainly if you're trying to share it with people. We certainly don't want to lose our data. The most common issue is that your data is somewhere else. You've moved computers. You've changed projects. You've tried to get your data off the cloud, something like that. And you get these annoying red exclamation points. The red exclamation point is basically the sign that your data has gone missing someplace. And this kind of stems back to one of the original definitions of GIS. Maybe not original, but one of the definitions of GIS, certainly. A container of maps. We could think about GIS as storing references to data on the hard drive. So we have a file, it's stored on our computer. GIS is a window that allows us to see what that file looks like spatially. Right, we need a special program to look at the data, see its spatialness, see its attributes, so on and so forth. However, if that path to the file, if the location where GIS is expecting to see that file results in nothing, it's going to exclamation point you. It's going to say, hey, wait a second. I don't know where that data is. Oh no, look at all those exclamation points. Correcting this problem, which I believe is the link on the previous page, correcting this problem is just as simple as repathing. So sometimes maybe you move a folder. Here's a really common way. You're working, got all your data, it's saved on a folder in the desktop. Love to see it. And then you put that folder maybe into like another folder, or you move it to a flash drive or something like that. And you're happy, maybe you're changing computers, or maybe you just put it in another folder to clean up your desktop, open it up the next day, red exclamation points. Easiest way is just to repath, click that exclamation point, and then guide it to the new data. Often everything blinks back on and you're happy. You're not happy when that data is on some other computer or when that data has been deleted by the gremlins that wipe, university or corporate machines now and then. So how do you avoid this? You be in control of your data. You are the practitioner. You control where you put your information, how you store it, how you save it, how you transfer it. You ask questions of yourself and of the people around you. How long does my data stay on this computer? How can I transfer it off? Is my profile networked to the cloud so I can grab it from anywhere? When are these machines wiped? Do I know how to use this laptop? All good questions. And above all else, protect your data. Backups. If you're in a lab course, you probably have backups on a course management page someplace. If you're working from state data, the state database is probably always going to be there. But if someone's like, hey, I'm going to give you this GIS data on this flash drive, can you do some analysis for me? Your first question as a practitioner should be, great, is this the only copy? Do you have a backup? Should probably make a backup anyway, no matter what the answer is. Data management, data understanding, data functionality, huge pieces of doing and thinking about GIS.